Good morning and welcome to the International Space Station Flight Control Room. This team is watching over systems on board the space station and following along with the activities of the Expedition 30 crew. This is the ISS update for Tuesday, January 17th. The crew on board the space station includes Commander Dan Burbank, astronaut overseeing the operations. He is joined by flight engineers, cosmonauts Anton Shkaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin and Oleg Kononenko, and NASA astronaut Don Pettit, and European Space Agency astronaut Andre Kuipers. This week, the crew members are focusing on research on board the space station. Here we see video that was recorded earlier today on board the complex with Pettit, and he was working on the Sphere's Zero Robotics activity, doing a dry run of use of those satellites. Sphere stands for the Synchronized Position Hold, Engage, Reorient, Experimental Satellites, and the Zero Robotics aspect is an educational activity. It establishes an opportunity for high school students to design research for the space station. As part of the competition, students write algorithms for the Sphere's satellites to accomplish various tasks that are relevant to future space missions. The algorithms are tested by the Sphere's team, and the best designs are selected for the competition to operate the Sphere's satellites on board the station. Pettit was doing a dry run of that activity today, and the main event, or the finals, are scheduled for next Monday, January 23rd. Other work Pettit is doing today involves the microgravity science glove box. A lot of work scheduled with that facility this week to get it ready for science activities. That is one of the major science facilities on board the space station inside the Destiny Laboratory. It provides a glove box particularly suited for handling hazardous materials when the crew is working with them. The crew was busy at work on Monday, even though it was a government holiday. It was not one observed on board the space station, so other science experiments were ongoing. Pettit continued work with experiments operating the capillary flow experiment called Vane Gap. The capillary flow experiments are a suite of fluid physics experiments that investigate capillary flows and flows of fluids in containers with complex geometries. Results from those experiments will improve current computer models that are used by designers of low-gravity fluid systems and may improve fluid transfer systems on future spacecraft. Without gravity, it is more difficult to control the flow of fluids, and this is a challenge for designing spacecraft systems such as liquid propellants, thermal control systems, wastewater management, and recycling. European Space Agency astronaut Andre Kuipers also worked with an experiment on Monday, actually putting away the equipment for one that was being used earlier, called the SODI experiment, the Selectable Optical Diagnostics Instrument, which is an aggregation of colloidal suspensions that will study the aggregation or mass phenomena of colloids in the microgravity environment. One of the most promising applications of colloidal engineering is the fabrication of photonic devices or technologies involving light, such as those used in telecommunications, robotics, and medicine applications. Other experiments have been operated by the cosmonauts on board, including a bar experiment that Shkaplerov worked on that is helping develop methods and instruments to help detect the location of a loss of pressure on board the station. And he also worked on an experiment with Ivanishin that is called Typologia, which is a behavioral assessment that the cosmonauts are undergoing. The ground team has been working on a tightly choreographed activity with the crew also. Starting on Monday, the team here in Mission Control started pushing a software update to the space station's computers, all of the major computers that control the station's systems and research on board. The transitions of several computers, including those that operate the systems and some of the laptop computers on board, the ones that the crew members use to interface with the station systems. That started on Sunday, and then astronaut Dan Burbank helped with that on Monday with those laptop computers, installing new hard drives and plugging those back in after some transitions were done with the major computers. And that work continues today and continues to go well as the team upgrades the software for enhancing the space station's operations and incorporating changes for future activities, including the visiting commercial vehicles, with the first of those planned to be from SpaceX, the Dragon vehicle, to demonstrate a rendezvous capability with the space station for cargo delivery. That first demonstration flight was targeted for a launch on February 7th, but SpaceX has informed NASA that it will need to delay that launch to ensure that the vehicle is ready to safely and successfully execute the planned mission.